Okay, I want to go through the sequence on how I cut these the vertical pins out here. So I've got everything marked, and you know, I've got everything scribed out. So let me just show you how I'm going to do it. I'll just get on with it here. So I put it down here in my moxen, and first thing I do is I just make sure that I'm good and level. It's going to kind of help me cut straighter. You know, I don't have a level floor in my shop, so just want to make sure my piece is good and level. And since I have a jacked up finger right now, I'm going to just give this moxen a little help here. And I've got my light, and this light's going to help me see these really fine scribe lines. So the very first thing you do is you take your good sharp chisel, and this is a nice, really, really sharp chisel. So you can see that I've got the waste marked here with the X. And so the first thing I want to do is I'm going to do all these on this side, and I put the chisel right in that line, and I bring it up until the bevel is almost perpendicular. I like to cheat and let it be a little bit on the outside so it's shifting over more, and I give myself a couple good wraps. And that's going to be the kerf line for my Japanese saw. And I only do them on this side, I don't flip. I found that when you do this kind of stuff, if you do everything and you keep your motion the same, you can be very, very consistent. If you start trying to do this one and this one and flipping around, you can, you know, it's hard to control your body mechanics. You lose concentration. But this way you just kind of get set in a almost in a human jig form. Okay, so there we go. Now here's my Hishiki rip saw with a stiffener on the back. And I never use wax as a lubricant on my saws, because once you get wax on these glue joints, you can never get it off. Now I'll just put a little coat of WD-40 on here, and the WD-40, you'll see that it'll mark the wood, but it will evaporate. And so it's not going to interfere with the glue down the road. And so what I do is I get ready and I put my Japanese saw in that kerf line, and I just give myself one, two, sometimes three, but mostly just two is good enough. And then I just move over to the next one, and I just try to make sure that I'm being super perpendicular, and just give myself a nice, and hold my body in the same exact position. And I kind of not only am I using my arms, but I'm also kind of rocking back on my heel in my stance. So I'm perpendicular, and I can see my scribe line going down, and so it really helps me maintain this very, very square cut. Okay, now I'm ready to cut down. So in here I go very easy, and I make sure that the saw is not binding and is relaxed. Okay, now I can cut. And I'm definitely not pushing down on the back stroke. And I don't have to worry about cutting. I just want to make sure that I leave myself a little bit this side. I don't want to cut too far. Nice and relaxed. Okay, looking good. This one I drifted ever so slightly to the inside of my cut, but I'll be able to clean that with the chisel. This one feels like it's a little bit bound. Let me get it straightened out and relaxed. Okay. light really helps when you have it low like this. It lets you see the shadow as it's passing through that scribe mark. This one's through that knot. Let me be real careful here. Oh, that's some weird stuff there. Little bit of lube for that baby. Okay, so I'll drill out from this side, get some waste, and I'll waste that with the coping saw, chop down, put it together.